Ix Astris is a fully-fledged, single-player JRPG made for mobile. This has left everyone wondering, when is it going to exploit my latent gambling addiction and leave me dead in a ditch with a handful of anime girls? The answer is never!
Whoa. Hang on, didn't we talk earlier about how it's not a JRPG at all?
We're getting there.
It's a sharpie G.
Ix Astris is a sci-fi by Hypergryph, the developers of Arknight, which means nothing to me, but hopefully that fills you with love and respect or whatever feeling you need that will make you spend the $10 upfront cost this game is asking for. Reportedly, the game is around about 14 plus hours to complete, and it has two endings. They're not dramatically divergent, so not really worth mentioning, but look, here we are. I should say that we shouldn't mention these endings I'm mentioning. It has a login at the start, but you can skip it and operate entirely offline. It's an absolute godsend because I burn through my data like a bushfire through a koala habitat. Man, I would have got a good laugh there, but Ratwife was sipping on some rat milk. The sniff test for whether a game has a good combat system is whether I'm willing to go out of my way for a scrap. Ix Astris nails it with an engaging hybrid turn-based system. During enemy turns, you have the chance to perfect parry, deflecting all damage and staggering your opponent when their bar gets down low enough. You also have to manage who is going to be blocking in real time, which gets tricky when only certain characters know how to not take a drill to the face. What I like about this system is that perfect parries mean that taking damage is entirely your own dumb fault. In most RPGs, taking at least a little damage is just the necessary wear and tear of encountering literally anything, similar to most of my relationships. I think I speak for all of us when I say there are a few people I wish I could have perfect parried.
Whoa.
Well, you're not one of them.
I thought we were talking sexually. Is a parry not sexual? I'm sorry.
Is a parry? Well, I don't know how your sex works.
Which one's the sexual one? The thrust or is it the parry?
The thrust or the parry?
I don't know, you just say both when you're fighting, all right?
I know you don't. Oh, yes you do. Yes you do. Attacking is also complex enough for anyone willing to dive deep into min-maxing combos. So far, I've been happy pretending I know what I'm doing in this department, slowly finding little tricks and synergies.
I mean, it's your life, isn't it?
Yes. just pretending I know what I'm doing. Finding little tricks and synergies. World design is split into tight zones, and who doesn't love a tight zone? To get to them, you jump aboard a space camper van which hides the load screen beautifully. During loading, you can cook for buffs and craft artifacts for your loadout, so you've always got something to do. And you can see out the window, you can see like the landscape going by. It's nice. Oh, and your loadout, it comes in like the form of like a jigsaw puzzle, so you've got to like arrange your artifacts like in an optimal sort of way. I'm playing on a Samsung Galaxy Note 20 5G, and it runs flawlessly at medium settings and good enough on max with 60 fps. It's aesthetically gorgeous even on medium settings. It goes for like a cool airy treatment, which helps distinguish it from Genshin's more snuggly warm schemes. I can almost smell the fresh air in this game. Unfortunately, unimaginary worlds can't mask the scent of bus farts, the natural habitat of mobile games. Controls feel great and the character moves as good as you'd expect from a standard AAA game, whatever, and not your standard shit Japanese RPG game, if you know what I mean, when you feel like you're kind of moving a box around. Writing, on the other hand, is almost beyond repair. My most uncharitable take is that it feels like they chucked the Chinese script through ChatGPT and then a guy who pretended to know English gave it a quick once-over. Writing also has an extremely bad case of the Glasglorbs, which is a term my friends came up with whenever I talked about grinding in Warframe, which invariably sounded like a listicle of made-up words James Cameron would think sounds pretty sci-fi. So you'll often read a paragraph you instantly don't remember because every second word means literally nothing to you. It's like playing an Alzheimer's simulator. The conversations people have barely feel like they're to each other most of the time. The terminology does slowly begin to make sense, but overall this script is getting gangbanged by a poor translation and the deadly fear of words used in a normal daily vocabulary. There's been a lot of chatter recently within the anime and gaming community over how translation work should be done, and I'm not gonna go waist deep into that shit, but it comes down to this. Translation work is an art, not a science. Ix Astris's translation feels like the most rigid ideal of trying to treat it like a mechanical science, and as a consequence, the human touch just feels entirely absent. With all that said, thank God this game has fantastic gameplay, because the wordplay does it no favors. Because the wordplay does it no...
Oh.
I'm not regretting this purchase, but you have been warned. Also, this is the end of video, but I want to add a little post note that it does have cloud saving that can pass between Android and Apple if you want to play on the iPad at home, but you'll have to buy the app twice. Okay, anyway, thanks for watching my video. Have a good one. Did you want to say anything, Ratwife? Well, the video stopped now.